Hello everybody, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to draw a bow tie by using for loops. I would like to set the width of one side of bow tie first, and then I will use this number to draw the bow tie shown on the slide here. Suppose the width is equal to 5, I will have this pattern with the width being 5 here and 5 there. So I will need to draw the stars by printing each of the rows appropriately. Okay, so let us see how we can implement it. The first thing to receive from the user is the number of stars on one side of a bow tie. So I have to get the user input like this. And since n is a string for now, I have to change it to an integer before I can use it for my for loops. The idea is use int command. And then I need to print out the bow tie one line by one line, so I have to set out the number of stars and spaces correctly. So my idea is like this. I have to create a line with the correct number of stars. Okay, I want to print the correct number of stars. If I is 0 for the time being, I would print out 1 star, because I will have 0 plus 1 which is equal to 1. If I becomes 1, I will have 2 stars. So if the width is 5, I will be equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So initially the number of stars on this string variable can help us create an increasing number of stars for each of the lines to be printed. And after printing out the sufficient number of stars on one side of the bow tie, I have to print out the number of spaces correctly. Okay, I want to add the correct amount of spaces after having enough number of stars on one side of the bow tie. Here, when I have 1 star on the far left, I need 4 plus 4, which is equal to 8 spaces. So how can I get this number correctly? I can use this expression. N, for example, is 5 now. If I is 0, I will have 5 minus 0 minus 1, which is equal to 4. So I will have 4 times 2, which is equal to 8 spaces. So I can complete the first line. I mean, I can complete the almost the entirety of the first line by giving 1 star followed by 8 spaces. And after I have set up the spaces, I have to give the number of stars on the right hand side correctly. Like this. So that I will add the same amount of stars as the left hand side. So in this case, I can fill in the first upper half of the bow tie, and after that, I have to print out the lower half of the bow tie like this. I have to use another for loop to help me do so. Now, if n is equal to 5, we just need to print out 4 more lines for the lower part of the bow tie. I have to reset the string. The number of stars to be printed will be equal to this one. When I have n equal to 5 and I equal to 0, I will have 5 minus 1 minus 0, which is equal to 4. So I will have 4 stars followed by the 5 stars on the previous line. And then I will print out the number of spaces correctly. By using this expression, I can print out the number of spaces correctly. Suppose n is equal to 5, and I is equal to 0, I simply want to print 2 spaces. After printing out the stars on the left hand side of a line, and of course I have to print out the stars on the right hand side to complete a line. So I will concatenate some other number of stars. Like this amount. In this case, I'm able to set up the same number of same number of stars on the left hand side. So for the right hand side, I will have a symmetric pattern which is equal to the number of stars on the left hand side of a line. And then after setting up the string, I have to print out the string. Same for here. So I have set up the lines for the upper half of the bow tie together with the lower half of the bow tie. So let us see the outcome. How about 5? Yes, I got it. 5 means the width on one side of the bow tie. So when I use the code here, I can control the number of spaces correctly. By reducing the number of spaces 1 line by 1 line on the upper half of the bow tie, and on the lower half of the bow tie, the number of spaces will increase appropriately, and of course the number of stars on each side of the bow tie will decrease appropriately. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the most efficient approach to the problem. If you can think about any idea to improve my code, feel free to post your code on the comment section below the video. And if you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.